Hello, my dear students. Today I am going to take about environmental issues in biozoology. Already we have completed about the environmental issues in biobotany. Now we will take some of the subtopics of biozoology. For a peaceful and healthy life, a clean environment is very important. Already we have studied about the environment, ecosystem, the problems of the ecosystem, we have studied in detail. So it is very important for the peaceful and healthy life, a clean environment is very important. But due to human activities and human negligence, our environment become dirty day by day and polluted. Earth is our environment. Earth is facing a lot of problems by air pollution, water pollution, noise pollution, global warming, acid rain, biomagnification, eutrophication, deforestation, waste disposal, ozone layer depletion, and climate change, etc. Over-exploitation of the natural resources from our planet and degradation of our environment also increases day by day in a very fast rate. So it is our duty to protect, preserve, and conserve the nature. Everyone should be aware of the environmental problems and try to solve in the individual level. When we are not protecting our environment, we have to face natural disasters striking us more often in the form of flash floods, tsunami, and cyclones. Pollution and increasing population, that is population explosion, are two main reasons to spoil the environment. What is pollution? Pollution is the undesirable changes that takes place in the physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of the environment due to the natural causes and human activities. Substances which cause pollution are called pollutants. The pollutants are classified into different types. There are two types of classification. In the first type of classification, it is based on the nature of pollutants which affects ecosystem. The pollutants are classified into number one, non-degradable pollutants, and number two, degradable pollutants. What are non-degradable pollutants? When the pollutants are not at all degraded, not at all broken down, or partially degraded and pollute the environment, they are called non-degradable pollutants. For example, aluminium, iron, mercuric salt, some phenolic compounds such as DDT, that is dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane, that is considered as the non-degradable pollutants. Come to degradable pollutants. When the pollutants are easily degraded or degradable or broken down into simpler substances by microorganisms, it is called degraded pollutants. The degraded pollutants are useful to the environment. Say for example, if you throw waste vegetables, kitchen waste, in the environment or in the soil, that is easily converted by microorganisms into simpler substances, that is the degradable pollutants. The second type of classification is based on and taken to break down into their gradients. So pollutants are classified as number one, rapidly degradable pollutants, or non-persistent pollutants. Second, slowly degradable pollutants are persistent pollutants. The third one, non-degradable pollutants. First, you will see rapidly degradable or non-persistent pollutants. When the pollutants cannot be broken down by natural process, that is called rapidly degradable pollutants or non-persistent pollutants. For example, domestic waste and vegetable waste, etc. Slowly degradable or persistent pollutants. When the pollutants take longer period to degrade, they remain in the environment for many years in an unchanged condition, then slowly degraded, that is called slowly degradable or persistent pollutants. They may take decades or longer to degrade. For example, DDT. DDT will persist in the soil for longer period in order to convert, in order to degrade. And the next one is non-degradable pollutants. When the pollutants cannot be degraded by natural process, they are called non-degradable pollutants. Once they are released in the environment, they are very difficult to eliminate and they continue to accumulate in the environment. And that process is called biomagnification. What is biomagnification? When the non-degradable pollutants are accumulated in the environment continuously, that process is called biomagnification. For example, lead, mercury, calcium, chromium, and nickel, and they are considered as non-degradable pollutants. They are toxic elements. They will cause many toxic effects to the environment. So these are all the different types of pollutants. Today we have seen about the environmental issues in general. Pollution, what is pollution? What are the different types of pollution classified? There are two types of classification according to the first type, non-degradable pollutants and degradable pollutants are given. According to the second type of classification, there are three types of pollutants given. First one, rapidly degradable pollutants. Number two, slowly degradable pollutants. And third one, non-degradable pollutants. That's all about today's topic. Thank you.